Lymph nodes help your body recognize and fight germs, infections, and other foreign substances. A swollen gland is an enlargement of one or more lymph nodes. We went to Desert Regional Medical Center in Palm Springs and spoke with Dr. Andrew Alexander, asking him to tell us why people get swollen glands.
Glands are important. Be glad you have them. Everybody needs them because if you don't have them, you have real trouble. They're part of the immune system. Lymphatic tissue is really what we're talking about here. The lymph system is a system where fluid is retrieved back from the peripheral tissues back towards the heart. Now, when that happens, it goes through a series of these glands or lymph nodes. Lymph glands are throughout your entire body. The most prominent ones that you'll see as a patient are going to be in your neck, your armpit, and your groin. And these are tissue, once again, that I said that fluid comes back into. Now, the most important thing about the fluid is that first it's being retrieved from the body so you don't swell up. But secondly, it's full of white blood cells, infection fighters, where these cells can identify foreign material, like viruses, like things that don't belong there, and then they become activated in the lymph nodes. They can magnify the response, and with some memory now, they can send out little infection fighters on white blood cells throughout the system to fight for their infection. It's normal to have an infectious response. You want to have an infectious response. You want to have your immune system activated to anything that's foreign. And so if you get a cold, you're going to swell up. Now, upper respiratory, the glands that are most prominent are the tonsils. The tonsils are part of the lymphatic system. The glands of the neck would often swell. If you have an eye infection or pink eye, you're going to have swelling right in front of the ears because that's where the drainage occurs as the lymph tissue goes towards the heart, towards that lymph node, where it activates and magnifies that response so that infection-fighting cells can be specific for that particular attacker. But there are also other things. Bacteria, the most common cause of an enlargement nowadays is cat scratch fever. A lot of cats run around the house, about half of them are infected with this bacteria, and so you can get a lymph node that might be enlarged. And we take lymph nodes out because sometimes they're malignant, but the large majority of those are infectious. And so there's lymph nodes that enlarge from bacterial causes. Some of the more famous ones in history, syphilis, tuberculosis, the bubonic plague. And these are things, whether they're bacteria or from ticks and bacteria from ticks, the bite occurs and the regional lymph node tries to wall off that infection. And sometimes it's a disaster because of these huge leaking nodes of the past. Today we have antibiotics, we cure those. Then there's the real problematic nodes. A very small amount of these are cancerous. And so depending upon the patient, we always want them to be very cognizant of the size and duration of these lymph nodes. If they get to within about 3/4 of an inch in size and they haven't gone away in a couple of weeks, you need to have a powwow with your doctor and let you and them together decide what the next step is. If they stay there, they get biopsied. And then there are high-risk people because there are some lymphomas. There are cancers of the lungs, there are breast cancers that go to their regional protective nodes. Breast cancer go to the armpit. Some of the lung cancers might make a node above the clavicle. So if you have a smoker who's been coughing and they have a lump up here, the so-called Virchow's node, that's problematic.
Dr. Alexander told us how serious swollen glands can be.
I remember when I was a kid, if you had a red streak going up your arm, the regional wisdom was that when it got to your heart, you died. Well, that's not really true. That's lymphangitis. Now, there'd be one where you'd treat, because the most common cause there would be a gram-positive bacteria, a staph or a strep. That would be treated with antibiotics. So that regional lymph node would be treated. A cat scratch fever would be treated. Tuberculosis and its associated nodes would be treated. But you're watching most of these and doing nothing, hoping they're viral. But time is on your side. You have a couple weeks. If they don't regress, if they stay 3/4 of an inch, 2 centimeters in size, it's time to talk to your doc with the thought that maybe there'll be a biopsy if the next treatment doesn't work.